Mathematical induction is often necessary to prove statements are true for all natural numbers. However, sometimes it's possible to avoid induction. This problem from number theory is one place where induction is avoidable. For any given integer n, our goal is to prove that the integers 5n+3 and 7n+4 are relatively prime to each other, also called coprime. That means they have no prime factors in common. It also means their GCD, or greatest common divisor, equals 1. And there's something called the GCD is a linear combination theorem that is the key to doing this proof. Before we do the proof, let's consider examples to help us believe this. This is something I advocate. Examples are not proofs, but they do help you believe facts to understand what they mean as well. So let's pick some different integer values of n, including negative values, like say negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And let's find the outputs of these expressions. In each case, when n is 0, this expression has a value of 3. And you can see because the rate of change of this expression with respect to n is 5, every time n increases by 1, the output's going to increase by 5, from 3 to 8, then to 13, then to 18, then to 23, etc. I could keep going. I can also let n decrease by 1, and the output's going to decrease by 5, from 3 down to negative 2, then negative 7, then negative 12, then negative 17. For this one, when n is 0, the output is 4, and because the rate of change is 7, as n increases by 1, we go up by 7 each time to 11, then 18, then 25, then 32. And as n decreases by 1, the output goes down by 7 each time to negative 3, then negative 10, then negative 17, then negative 24. It's a pretty amazing fact. No matter what n is, as you look across a given row like here, the two numbers are relatively prime. They are coprime to each other. 18's prime factorization is 2 times 3 squared. 25 is 5 squared. They have no primes in common. The greatest common divisor of these two numbers is 1. So, how in the world are we going to try to prove this without using induction? And what is the hint that maybe induction is not relevant? Well, one hint is that we are trying to prove this for all integers, positive or negative, instead of just, say, natural numbers, which are positive integers. However, that's not really the key reason, because you, in such a situation, you could really use induction twice. Once for the positive integers and once for the negative integers, and say 0 as a special case. So it's not really the key reason. The key reason induction is not necessary, though you really could use it, is that the truth of these two things being relatively prime for a given n is not really dependent on it being true when n is 1 smaller, when you replace n by, say, n minus 1. Why is that? And how do we use the GCD as a linear combination theorem? What we want to do is we want to ask the question. I'm going to write backwards E for there exists. Does there exist integers, S and T, Z means the integers, which is both positive integers and negative integers, and 0. Do there exist integers, S and T, such that, ST means such that, 5n+3 times S plus 7n+4 times T equals 1. If that's true, if there are such integers for a given value of n, that would mean 5n+3 and 7n+4 are relatively prime. This is called an integer linear combination of these two numbers. S and T are integers. Is this true? And it would be especially nice if S and T were consistent no matter what n is. Is there a choice of S and T that makes this true no matter what n is? You could pause the video here and try some guessing, and you should be able to guess the answer. The answer is there are S and T's that work here. But in case you can't see it by guessing, let's think about it a bit more systematically. What we could do is we could multiply the S and the T through the parentheses with the distributive property, and first group together the coefficients of the n term. They would be 5s and 7t, 5s plus 7t times n. Effectively, I'm looking at s times 5n and t times 7n and factoring out the n. The terms that do not involve n are 3s and 4t. Does this equal 1 for all n? These things would be equivalent to each other. What we get really is a system of linear equations. The n term, because there's no n on the right side, would have to have a coefficient equal to 0. 5s plus 7t would have to be 0, and the constant term that does not involve n, 3s plus 4t, would have to equal the constant over there, 1. Now, such a system of linear equations certainly has a unique solution. But in general, S and T could be fractions, not integers. So what we're really after here are integer solutions. You could try to solve this in the usual kind of way by elimination or substitution, but I will just go ahead and guess. Certainly if S is, say, 7 and T is negative 5, this first equation is true. Also, that would be true if S were negative 7 and T were positive 5. But we also want to make the second equation true. And a little bit of guesswork reveals if you choose S to be 7 and T to be negative 5, that's an integer solution of both equations. Double check it. 5 times 7 is 35. 7 times negative 5 is negative 35. 35 plus negative 35 is 0. With the second equation, 3 times 7 is 21. 4 times negative 5 is negative 20. 21 plus negative 20 is 1. There we have it. That's what we're after. And that's going to be the key reason why 5n plus 3 and 7n plus 4 are relatively prime. And it's independent of n. It doesn't depend on n. And so we can do this proof without induction. Let's go ahead and do the formal proof now. Let's start by just saying let n in the integers be given. Since we are saying it's a given arbitrary integer, that will effectively prove these are relatively prime for all integers. And again, I don't need induction. Note that we don't even have to think about rewriting our scratch work here. The scratch work was just to help us think about it. We can just go ahead and plug in s equals 7 and t equals negative 5 right away. Go ahead and write out this expression, 5n plus 3 times, go ahead and replace s right here with 7. 5n plus 3 times 7 plus 7n plus 4 times negative 5 equals, go ahead and simplify this, 5n times 7 is 35n, 3 times 7 is 21, 7n times negative 5 is negative 35n, and 4 times negative 5 is minus 20. This simplifies to 1, and it's independent of n, though you don't need to mention that, again, because I've already emphasized that n is an arbitrary given integer. Therefore, we're essentially done. By the GCD is a linear combination theorem. I'm assuming you know this, okay? If you need to know some number theory, I've got some other videos about that theorem that you can see here. Look in the description. By the GCD is a linear combination theorem. This means the GCD of 5n plus 3 and 7n plus 4 is 1. And by definition, that means 5n plus 3 and 7n plus 4 are relatively prime. You could also say they are coprime. It means the same thing. And that means we're done. QED, we're done. Let me end by showing you that you can also verify this in kind of a fancy way on Wolfram Alpha. I'm going to use what's called Mathematica code to make a table of true false values based on whether the given quantities 5n plus 3 and 7n plus 4 are relatively prime or not. You can do table square bracket coprime q, meaning are these things coprime, 5n plus 3 and 7n plus 4, and put a comma, and then go curly brace n comma, say, negative 10 comma 10. And what we should get, if these things truly are relatively prime no matter what n is we should get a bunch of trues. These are a bunch of coprime numbers. The output is all true, and that would be the case even if I let n go over a bigger range of values and re-enter it. We get a bunch of trues, no falses. That's Wolfram Alpha's way of saying 5n plus 3 and 7n plus 4 are indeed coprime no matter what value of n we choose. Thanks for watching.